the good candidates don't necessarily make themselves stand out. And that's mm-hmm. the tricky thing as well. And then maybe we can talk about, you know, how can a candidate, I think technology people are not infamously bad at putting resumes and applications together. I mean, it's so seldom that I see a fantastic one. And when they do, they really stand out. Everything from presentation of the resume to answering the questions correctly, or sometimes even following up applications, etc.
Right. Yeah, that's a very good point. Well, it's they're in a tricky position because many of the systems don't, for good reasons. Yeah, they don't. I mean, if you've got 1,000 resumes in the last 24 hours, the last thing you want is 1,000 follow-up emails, right? Even though it might be a nice idea from the candidate side, but it's just, it's functionally unmanageable for you. And so I am of the opinion that someday we will be out of the resume business.
It's amazing that the process of recruiting really hasn't changed that much, despite LinkedIn, despite job boards, despite so much. At the end of the day, we still have to have these face-to-face interviews and tech tasks, and it's still such a cumbersome process.
Sure. Well, I think it's funny that you mentioned that, because I actually make the argument that not only – isn't it easier, but the technology that we rely on and that helps us in so many areas of our lives actually exacerbates some of the problem when it comes to hiring and getting hired. And I can tell you what some of those are. I'm in general not going to complain or rip on the industry unless I have a solution and something valuable for your listeners. But I'll start by saying that, you know, you're exactly right. There are, you know, despite a huge proliferation of new technology and businesses operating very different, there haven't been drastic changes in the actual process that companies use to recruit people.